What is up, guys and girls? My name is Justin Omoi. This is the Antelope Pure 2 Mastering ADDA Converter with KFC. And today, what I want to do is unbox it, try it out, give it my shot, my test, and of course use it, obviously. Digital clarity, analog warmth. Oh, here we go again with this mumbo jumbo, right? Precise clocking, don't care. High-end headphone amp, that's what I do care about, that's good. User-friendly device management. Ultra high performance components, which is what we really care about, is the actual converter itself, right? We are greeted with the book. Oh yes, I love the smell of these type of books, man. I love the smell of these type of like plasticky things. Oh yeah, baby. It smells the same. And here we go, styrofoam up. Power cord, nice and slick and schmoove. We have a very, oh my god. I thought it said my name, Andy. Oh, hold on. They keep trying to sneak these in. Oh, wait, what the fuck is this? I'm gonna be completely honest with y'all. I don't know what this is. Maybe some sort of tube thing? Like a plasma for like, I'd like to hear your guys' guesses on it. I thought that was candy. All right, well, here is this thing. Pure 2. Heavy stuff. This is very, very heavy, and I'm very happy about it being heavy. It's like not exactly white too. I don't know if the word off-white actually resembles. It's like a polar snow white. Right off the bat, we got the PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3. We have a speaker or headphones flipping a switch. The knob, the pushable knob. We have frequency up and down. This is for the radio when you want to listen to 95.3 or 101 jams or AM 1560. The rest of the stuff over here, we have a power button. It's a clicky button, so it's not a push-in switch. We have the oven, we have the lock, and we got 10M. I don't know. I got to read this thing, okay? I got to read it. We got the word clock and then the 10M, which is a faster version of the word clock and speed. Next up, we got the spiff in and out, as well as the TOS link in and out. It's fiberglass or some shit. We got AES in, AES out. Don't ask me what AES is. Over here, we got multiple word clock outs. That's to, you know, have this thing go out to other devices. So they're like, okay, this is where we gotta go. Let's stay synchronized. Let's do our thing at the right time. Oh, let's do it. And the last section here is our inputs, outputs, lefto and righto. I don't think I'll be using this for like the speakers, as weird as it sounds, but look at this. You see that move? It's not this port, it's actually the black thing itself, the black port of the cantaloupe. Let me go ahead and I'm gonna plug it in, I'm gonna read this whole book out, and then we'll do some fun. Right here is the output audio capture. If I double click it, this is set on default. Okay, so default means whatever the computer is using, it's gonna use that. I'll go to the sound piece here and I'll flip them back and forth from the Focusrite to the Pure 2 to the Focusrite, and we'll take a listen to both of them. And I'll be using the focal clears, and as much as I hate pulling out these wires and plugging them in, I gotta do it. I don't know if it translates well in the video, because obviously I didn't hear it. I'll check actually and then tell y'all. But I hear such a difference from this Antelope. I'm not even bullcrapping y'all, man. I'm not trying to justify the damn price that I spent for this. But I hear such a difference. Oh my god, it's like I went from the Scarlett to the Clarett, and I heard, remember that video? And I heard like sounds that I never heard before. With this, I hear depth. I hear depth in that lower end. I don't know what it is. I might be going crazy. It feels like there is a flat wall right here on the bass, on that bass, that depth. It's like there's a flat wall right there and it says, nope, Focusrite, nope, you're not able to. Nope, you're not capable of doing that.
I don't know what it is. I mean, obviously, the price difference in quality is probably what it is, but I can't even comprehend it. That's how, you know, thing it is. So yeah, the video does play like I had thought. You do hear a difference throughout the, you know, two interfaces when I went back and forth. So that's cool. But one more thing I want to show you guys and girls. I pretty much took that same beat loop, put it through the mastering gear. I didn't change any of the numbers on the gear because it's somebody else's thing right now. Then I brought it back into the audio interface as well as the Pure 2. I record them and then I flipped the Focusrite one over. The polarity is flipped so you get that canceled out so we can see what kind of difference it makes here. I tried my best to line everything up as you can see in the computer here. Once I scroll in, you'll see here. Bam, and let me just double click and show you there. So let me go ahead and hit play and we'll adjust this here. So yeah, as you can see, I lowered the volume, I upped the volume just to find the right sweet spot to cancel the most of it out. I don't know, but I will leave both of these files. Check the link in the description below so you could be able to play around with these signals as well. Maybe you don't feel like you hear enough justice because it's all, you know, encoded. And I'd love to hear your opinions and thoughts about the Antelope Pure 2. Mine is that this thing is just spectacular. The only downside I feel is the fact that they only have two screw hole ports rather than four. So let me show you what I mean here. It looks like they went for style more than, you know, function here with the screws. That's really my only complaint about the device, but other than that, this device is just a whole new level of amazing. You know, this is, I was kind of like feeling hypocritical about it, but now I feel like I understand why. I understand why, you know, professional mastering is used with this stuff, you know, which is why I also bought it so I could finally finish out my rack gear to have a mastering or professional mastering chain for my clients. If you would love to be one of my clients and improve your own music to its fullest extent, hit your boy up at justinomoi.com. Email me, we could talk from there. But yeah, thank you for watching my video. It is your boy, Justin Omoi. And yeah, peace. I'm out. Please have yourselves a damn good one.